Welcome to this tutorial where we'll explore and explain Pytrees, an important concept in the JAX library that can transform how you work with data structures. We'll start by setting up our environment. First, we'll connect to a TPU runtime, though you can use a CPU instead if you're following this tutorial at home. After connecting, we'll install the JAX library using pip, making sure to include the TPU components as well. Now let's understand what a Pytree is. At its core, it's a nested structure that can contain different types of Python containers, such as lists, tuples, and dictionaries. Within these containers, we have what we call leaves. A leaf is any piece of data that isn't a container, like a single number or an array. Pytrees are particularly valuable in machine learning applications. They can store various types of data, such as model parameters, dataset entries, or observations from reinforcement learning agents. If you've ever found yourself struggling to manage complex, nested data structures in your machine learning projects, Pytrees offer an elegant solution. For instance, you might work with datasets that contain lists of dictionaries. These are all examples of Pytrees. One important function we can use with Pytrees is JAX tree leaves, which helps us see all the individual values or leaves in our Pytree. These leaves represent the final individual pieces of data nested within our containers, no matter how deep they are buried in the structure. The concept of flattening is crucial in understanding Pytrees. In JAX, any structure built from Python container objects can be treated as a Pytree. By default, common Python containers like lists, tuples, and dictionaries are already recognized as Pytree containers because they're included in what's called the Pytree registry. Any object whose type isn't in this registry is automatically treated as a leaf node. One exciting feature is that we can expand the Pytree registry by adding our own custom container classes. We just need to register our class and specify how it should be flattened. Let's explore how we can work with and manipulate Pytrees using some common functions. One of the most useful operations is called mapping, which allows us to transform data throughout our tree structure. Imagine having the power to apply a single function to every piece of data in your nested structure, regardless of how deep it's nested. This is exactly what the tree map function enables. For example, if we want to double every number in our Pytree, we can use tree map with a simple function that multiplies by 2. What makes this particularly powerful is that it works transparently across the entire structure. Even if we add more layers of nesting to our lists, all the numbers will still be multiplied by 2. The function automatically reaches every level of the tree structure without us having to write complex nested loops. Importantly, it also does this in a way that's parallelizable and works well with compiler optimizations. Let's see how this applies to a real machine learning scenario, specifically when training a multi-layer perceptron, or a type of neural network. We can use tree map to examine our initial parameters by looking at their shapes. This is done by applying a function that returns X shape to every parameter in our model. When training the model, we organize our parameters in a Pytrees structure, which provides a clean and efficient way to update them. An important detail to understand is that when we calculate gradients or grades for our model, these gradients automatically form a Pytree with the same structure as our parameters. This is possible because JAX functions like JAX grad are built to work seamlessly with Pytrees. Another important concept in Pytrees is the idea of key paths. Every leaf in a Pytree has what we call a key path. Think of it as an address that shows exactly where that piece of data lives in the tree. The key path is a list of keys, and its length tells us how deep the leaf is nested in the tree. We can see these paths using a special function called JAXTreeUtilTreeFlattenWithPath, which shows us both the keys and the flattened version of our Pytree. When we look at a flattened Pytree structure, we'll notice different types of keys. For lists and tuples, we use sequence keys, while dictionaries use their own dictionary keys. It's worth noting that none values are treated specially. They're considered non-existent rather than being treated as leaves. This means you won't see none values appearing in your key paths or in the flattened tree structure. Let's finish up by exploring an important operation called transposing, which is sometimes necessary when analyzing Pytrees. Transposing a Pytree is like reorganizing its structure in a different way, similar to how you might reorganize rows and columns in a spreadsheet. What's convenient about this operation is that it can often be done with minimal specification because JAX can figure out the inner structure based on the outer structure and the tree itself. For example, if you have a Pytree that represents multiple batches of data, transposing might help you reorganize it to group similar elements together. JAX makes this process straightforward, and you don't always need to specify every detail of the transformation because the structure can often be inferred automatically. Now let's wrap up by understanding why Pytrees are so valuable in the JAX ecosystem. At their core, Pytrees provide an elegant abstraction for handling complex nested data structures. They give us convenient functions for manipulating these structures, but their value goes beyond just organization. Pytrees are particularly powerful because they work efficiently with core JAX transformations and a variety of hardware scenarios. Three key JAX tools work seamlessly with Pytrees: vmap for automatic vectorization, grad for calculating gradients, and JIT for just-in-time compilation. These tools can automatically work with your nested data structures thanks to the Pytree abstraction, making it much easier to write efficient and clean code for machine learning applications. The beauty of Pytrees is that they solve a common problem in machine learning, managing complex, nested data structures in a way that's both efficient and easy to work with. Whether you're handling model parameters, dataset features, or reinforcement learning observations, Pytrees provide a consistent and powerful way to organize and manipulate your data. If you'd like to support the channel, consider starting a free trial of our new design tool, which is linked in the description, and let us know what you think. We'll include a link to the documentation in the description as well. If you have any questions, please post them in the comment section and we'll do our best to respond. Thank you very much for watching to the end, and please enjoy responsibly.